And we're glad you're listening to us here on 99.9. You're entering In the Last Days. It is our show here on WCC, and it runs on Tuesday, every Tuesday from 7 to 8. And me and Pastor RPI, we are in here having a good time, and yep. We just kind of got carried away, I reckon, and time caught up with us.
Yeah, we got here a whole hour.
We got here a whole hour early, and we got to talking over all kind of things. And if we just share half of what we talked about with these guys, they're going to have their mind just overturned, ain't it?
Yeah, we'll be too much.
We're going to talk about the Gog and Magog war some tonight, just because of the things that are going on right now in the Middle East, and especially with Russia moving in the direction that they're moving.
That's right.
But before we do, brother, I think you got us a song, don't you?
Yes, this is the right song for the right hour. It's Jeremy Kemp, and it's called There Will Be the Days. We those days where you don't have to worry about no crime, no tears, no pain, no nothing.
And Jesus coming.
That's right.
That'll be the day.
That's right.
I try to hold on to this world with everything I have, but I feel the weight of what it brings and the hurt that tries to grab. The many trials that seem to never end, His word declares this truth, that we will enter in this rest with wonders anew. But I hold on to this hope and the promise that He brings, that there will be a place with no more suffering. There will be a day with no more tears, no more pain, and no more fear. Jesus face to face, but until that day, we'll hold on to You always. I know the journey seems so long, you feel you're walking on your own. There has never been a step, but you've walked out all alone. Troubled soul, don't lose your heart, 'cause joy and peace He brings, and the beauty that's in store. How is the hurt of life sting? But I hold on to this hope and the promise that He brings, that there will be a place where no more suffering. There will we'll
All right, brother. There will be a day, and it won't be long from now.
You're right on. You're right on, because it ain't going to be long, man.
Jesus said, when you see these things come to pass, look up, because your redemption draweth nigh. And I believe that we all need to be looking up, because if the saints of God's fixing to go home.
Oh, yeah.
It's exciting times, Brother RPI. I'll tell you the truth. It is exciting to watch events right out of Scripture. It's like they walked right out of the page, huh?
Oh, yeah.
It's like Russia just walked right out of the page when it talks about Gog and Magog. Syria walked right out of the page. You began to talk about Iran. Used to be called Persia. We'll talk about that in a minute, Ezekiel 38 and 39. Hey, it's walking. I see the Word of God just coming right out of the page like it's starting a movie. You know what I mean? And we're just going to sit down and watch a movie that's already been recorded thousands of years ago. And it's just that now it's time for the movie to be showed.
Oh, yeah.
And, man, it is exciting times. There's a great deception. And I was talking to Sister Sandy today, one of our loyal listeners, and I know she's listening now.
Hey, Sister Sandy.
But I was talking to Sister Sandy today, and she was really excited and energetic about all the things that are going on around the world. And we kind of concluded in our discussion that it is the spirit of the Antichrist that is on the march. It's not just in America, but it is in America. And the spirit of the Antichrist is working in the nations around the world, and it is drawing them to where they need to be to fulfill biblical prophecy. They need to be right around Israel.
That's right.
I mean, China, from what we just understood just a couple of days ago, joined Russia
September 26th
in their military endeavors.
That's right.
To supposedly
fight ISIL.
Supposedly. We know that, you know, by what we learned off of, well, our news media, for what you can trust it with.
Well, see, that's why I go to Jerusalem Post.
That's the only way to get good news.
That's the only way.
It is. So it seems to us that the Russians are bombing Assad's enemies, not necessarily ISIS, but Assad's enemies that's trying to tear down his reign of terror.
That's right.
Is supported by the United States. And so that's backed our president up in a corner. And our president, he's like he just can't beat his way out of a wet paper sack. So, yeah, pretty much whooped. And so I think in the very near future, we will see a less and less of America involved in this Syrian crisis and what's going on. And we already have seen in the last 2 years, Russia come down and began to do all kind of things.
That's right.
So these things, this Gog and Magog war,
it's
shaping up.
This is a live movie. You ever seen a live movie?
So, yeah, you're watching it unfold. If
you got eyes to see, yeah.
And ears to hear, you can watch this movie.
It is. And it's getting to the point where it's like, you know, we supposed to be the so-called superpower, the superheroes, and help everybody, and we're not doing that. And we just actually bombed a hospital.
Yeah, that's a sad.
It's sad.
That's very sad. Doctors Without Borders. We killed several of them and many of their patients. And they say that the airstrike was not called in by our special forces units, but it was called in by some Afghan units, and that they called it in, and America responded. And they're not supposed to do that. They're supposed to work through the channel.
That's
so
right.
You know, that's what they say now, brother. But they, let me tell you, they'll say anything to get the monkey off of their back.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I do not trust two things. Number one, I don't trust the United States of America's government.
That's
and
right.
Number two, I don't trust media. Because
right.
The media gets its news from government sources 90% of the time. And if government sources twist the media's arms hard enough, they'll only report what they're told to report.
That's right. And it's just like... It's just like where things are happening right now that we are losing our sovereignty. You know, we're losing everything. We're not into the area where we used to be the powerhouse. Now there's other countries. You got Russia, which is Russia made a deal with Assad. Those who like, well, who is Assad? Well, Assad is the president of Syria.
Right.
That is the same man that used nuclear weapons.
Well, he used chemical weapons.
Chemical weapons on his own people.
His own people.
You know, in Damascus, right? I'm saying that right? In Damascus, Syria?
It was somewhere in that area.
In that area, yeah.
So, but then we were heavy. We were fixing to do something to Syria and Assad's regime because, you know, there was such an outcry of the world against what Assad had done. And then who appears out of nowhere but Russia? And Russia says, we will take and disarm them.
That's right.
And so Esau said, come on down here, buddy. Help me get, you know, help it look like we got all our weapons and help me out. So he did.
That's right.
But that was the end of that for a while.
Yep.
And so we tried to undercut Assad's regime by arming the rebel forces that were fighting to overthrow Assad's regime.
That's exactly right.
And so they were doing a pretty good job, I reckon, but not enough so that they were toppling him in the last, what, 3 or 4 years.
Yeah.
So here's Putin back again.
Putin back.
And he's here to uphold his buddy.
Yeah, he uphold him. We're going to help you fight ISIS. As long as you give me some of that oil and gas, that's what they're saying, that Russia did make a deal with Assad and Syria that, okay, we will help you, but we need some fuel, we need gas, we need the essentials that they put a sanction on us because of the situation in Ukraine. We can't forget about Ukraine. So what we did was that we want to help you if you help us. So that's what's happening. Now, where did China come in with that? I do not know. They still trying to figure out from the Jerusalem Post that what is the purpose of China coming in as a superpower, you know, to help Russia. They send their J-15s and they are bombing ISIL. And then Putin go out and say, well, listen, America, Obama's lying to y'all. They are not hitting what they supposed to be hit, but then at the same time, Russia ain't hit what they supposed to be hit. They saying they are knocking out ISILs and killing them, and they've got
a media propaganda machine.
Yeah. So
running.
We don't know what to believe,
and that's the truth.
We don't know
because I believe there's a propaganda machine
that's
as big in America as you're going to find anywhere in the world, and Russia definitely has one. China,
yes,
is nothing but controlled media.
That's right.
So whatever you hear coming out of China, if it come from a governmental source, you can pretty much say it's slighted to make the government of China look right in what they're doing. And by the way, you know, I don't know if anybody really pays attention, but Syria has a warm port, and they have been in cahoots with Russia for a long time, and Russia has kept their ships there, some of their naval fleet, and so that gives them a base of operation in a port that doesn't freeze over and closer to other countries of the world. So it is a good relationship between Syria and Russia, not only between them, but between Iran, and not only between them, but now you got to add China to the mix.
That's right. And China is a big major player. You know, I think it was the leader or I can't think of his name. He came down from China at the time the Pope came down, and him and Obama, they claimed that, you know, they had a little talk about, you know, hacking each other and they, you know, emails and the Hillary Clinton thing, because they say that's where most of that came out because of that and all that. And they had a little powwow, so I don't know how well it went. And he left and went back, and Obama went back. So, you know, it's getting to a situation where Ezekiel 38 is really starting to come to life.
Literally comes to life. And, you know, just throwing some things in that I've learned over the last few months is that, you know, we accuse China of taking a lot of our secrets, you know, military secrets. But if you looked at their fighter jets, their up-to-date modern fighter jets, it is an exact mirror of our brand new up-to-date fighter jets.
They have
the same equipment because they stole our plans, our documents, and they built the same one, and we spend billions and billions to develop it.
That's right.
They steal the plans, and they've got it for free. Why doesn't our government go and say, you did this wrong? We're going to put all kind of trade tariffs on you. We're not going to let you stock market trade. We're going to shut you down. Why? Because we already owe them so much money.
That's right.
And by the way, they buy some of our products. We buy theirs. So this is a mess.
But here's the thing, though. We give them the patent to build it.
This is crazy.
Well, I mean, what you expect going to happen? If I got a big thriving business and I need somebody to make this chip for me, and you my competitive, I'm like, well, I'm going to go to you and ask you to build this for me for half the price in America because I want to save about $3 trillion. Then guess what? You have my patent.
Well, you know exactly how to set the stuff up.
Thank you.
You give them the knowledge. You give them the technology
and
the tools to do it. So we have shot ourselves in both feet.
They stole it, and then we give it to them.
Yep.
You get everything made in China. I remember watching a movie one time. It was Armageddon, and the astronaut was flying in the sky. And the guy was like, let's get out of here from the blow up. And then the Russian lady like, listen, this is some delicate. No, American lady said, listen, this is some delicate stuff. He said, oh, no, no, no. He beats it. All of it made in China. And he was hitting on it, and they went to work. See, I told you.
Yes,
so this is what we do. We give them our top technology because we don't want to take the time and the money to build it because we don't want to spend $10 million or $40 billion. So we take it to China and spend $40,000, $60,000 in China. Like, oh, wow, okay, we can. This we is got the this. Codes. Yeah, okay, so we do that. And they'll use it, but they'll change the color on it and put different name and fly right beside. Hey, that look like my.
Yeah, exactly like my plane.
Just different color. Yeah. So
yeah. So the Gog and Magog of Ezekiel 38 and 39, very much alive, very much unfolding right before our eyes. And so I wanted to talk a little bit about that and a few other events that's happening even here in America.
Oh, yeah.
Right here in America, we just had South Carolina just swamped. We literally was swamped with rain for about 2.5 days consistently, heavily. And then the winds came. And I know that right there in Johnston, there were several major trees down and knocked power lines down when they hit them and broke power poles. There was a mess around Johnston.
I-20 still climb. I-20 is still closed off the exit of Saluda with a bridge. They say water is running. They say that over 7 dams has broken.
Yeah.
The big dam. What's the big dam? Hoover. What's the big dam in the lake?
You got major lakes. You got Lake Greenwood. You got Lake Russell. You got Lake Strong Thurmond. You got Clark's Hill. Well, that's Strong Thurmond. You've got what's the one at Lake Murray?
Yes, they say that Lake Murray. They were trying to release some water out of Lake Murray, and it busted open.
Really? Literally, just got the repair in that dam. Well, and they said shoring that dam up just a couple years ago.
And they say that they are leaking. They can't even close it. They said they can't even close down because so much water, so much force. And guess what all that water going to? Savannah River.
Well, now that river coming out of, that is the Saluda River, I believe, coming out of Lake Murray. So that would have to be one of the Clark Hill Dam. That's the Savannah River that comes through there.
That's right. So some of that water, because, you know, our job used Savannah River, and we got a level where when we get back there, we might have to get a boat to get back to the back part of the, our pond. So a lot of things are happening. I mean, they showing pictures of roads collapsing. One in the fields, the football field, all you see is the post hanging out. You don't see the state. You see maybe 10 bleachers.
So why? Why have these?
Yes, why?
This was
that?
A very, and the I heard the meteorologist talking about how rare this is. It's like a 1-in-1,000-year rain event. So that the likelihood of it happening any given year is 1-in-1,000. And I heard these meteorologists look at the scenario that set itself up, and they said this is almost never going to happen again. It's just a 1-in-a-lifetime event that all of these circumstances happen to funnel this water like a hose pipe right over South Carolina. It's amazing. It wasn't everywhere. It was over South Carolina.
Over South Carolina.
And so what was God saying to South Carolina is what I want to know.
He's telling us to wake up. That's what he's saying.
I believe that when you read your Bible, especially in the Old Testament, when God wanted to warn a nation, he would send a small strike against the nation. And usually it would be a small invasion from a foreign nation, and it was sent to wake them up to turn their hearts back towards God.
If they
didn't heed the warning of a small invading army, then God would turn around and send a large army to totally destroy them. So here's the way that this is God's mode of operation. He sends warnings. And then if you do not heed the warning and repent and turn back to God, then he brings in the judgment.
That's
brother,
right.
I believe that God is showing us something.
He is.
And it has to do with water. It has to do with water because there's been many, many prophets and many dreams about a great, what do they call that, a tsunami coming against all of the East Coast. And somebody says, how in the world did you dig that out of what happened? Well, I just look at things a little different than everybody else does.
That's right.
I try to look at the Bible and say, how does God operate? And could this be a warning? And if it's a warning, has God ever warned in these similar ways? And I'd say, well, yes, God has. And so from that, I can draw my conclusions. But the Gog and Magog war is setting itself up right there in the Middle East Other things are going on around the world. The United States has really been crippled because of natural disasters.
That's right.
Here recently, when you talk about the California drought and then the California and Washington, Oregon floods, firestorms, then what you see is, well, you know, that's just the other side, but now it's hitting on our side. It's come through the middle of our state. It was dry a few years ago, desperately dry. Cattle were dying everywhere. There was no food for them. And then you fast forward a couple of years, and now they're getting a deluge of rain through the center. And we see all of these natural disasters, and it's depleting our food sources.
That's right.
We get a lot of our fresh vegetables, especially our nuts and citrus, from California.
That's right.
And all of those things have dried up.
That's right.
Most all of them have.
And you know how that fire started?
It's a lightning.
Lightning. Seven lightning strike started that fire.
So isn't this amazing? I mean, these weren't started by man. They
That's
were started
right.
by natural causes. And God controls everything, but he definitely controls nature.
And that's amazing.
He has his way in the wind and the whirlwind.
That's right. And they say that in California that the wind, because it's so, so dry, the wind is just shifting. It's getting to the point where they actually see fire just come in the whirlwind like a tornado.
Yeah.
And it takes, it even showed when they was on the bridge and how that fire shifted and burned like maybe 25 something cars or 20 cars, something like that. We got fire in the west and we got
floods
water
in the east.
Floods in the east.
Yeah. And so what is it? God is saying something.
Yes, he is.
And America has not yet even heard. The majority of Americans, now I know that they're Christians like us, and they see and their eyes are open and their ears are open, and they see that these are preliminary judgments. But here's what I keep telling the people. God spoke this in my church, and I've heard him, that he has spoken over the internet to some other prophets as well, is that things will escalate from this point on. It's not going to get better. It's not going to turn around because America has not yet repented. We always got the answer, but today we don't have the answers. We can't stop the fires. We can't stop the floods. What can we stop? We think we've got answers, but what can we do to stop what God is doing? Absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
And it's going to accelerate.
And then in Oklahoma, they took the Ten Commandments down, and they did it at nighttime.
Is that right?
Yeah, that just happened. They took it down. They made a big fuss about it. We are tired of seeing it. We want it out, and they took it down. They had a big mantelpiece of the Ten Commandments sitting right there, and they done it at nighttime.
And so we're in trouble, brother.
We in a lot of trouble.
And
you can't sit up there and take God out of everything that this country was based on and expect God to still operate. It don't work like that. Just like that shooting in Oregon. Terrible, terrible thing. That's probably the worst thing that you can ever experience. But then the nation wants to pray. Oh, let's pray. But when are we going to pray when everything is going good? When are we going to give God his glory?
Yeah.
And, you know, and it's sad because this guy went into a school and asked each
targeted
person,
Christians.
Christian.
Where is
Christian?
The outcry? Those had to have been a different religious sect. Let's just say Muslims.
Oh, yeah.
Obama would have been on the TV denouncing it. There would have been other organizations crying out against this as hate crimes and violence against religious, peaceful religions. And now that it's Christians, though, it seems to be mighty quiet on the front because it's okay to hate Christians.
It's all right.
The majority.
It's amazing, you know. And I'm not hating on Obama. I'm not. I'm just saying. I'm just. It is what it is, you know. Here, this guy got shot seven times to try to fight, take this guy down to save people. He's alive. You ain't hear nothing from Obama. But then a young boy, Muslim young boy, built a clock, which actually was a bomb, which his father is one of the radical Islam that's part of this group over there, go to the White House.
Something's wrong with our picture.
Something wrong with that picture. So that tells me that he does not care about skin. Everybody wants to say, well, it's all this race. No, that ain't got nothing to do with it. Obama just cares about Muslims. I'm sorry.
I'm not sorry. I mean, it's true.
You know, it's true.
Just look at the track
record. We are seeing it. We are seeing the doors, you know, stuff he is saying, and he's putting out there. He is not hiding it. He is telling it, you know, and the Christians are right now getting persecuted. This is what's happening. We are getting persecuted. We're getting beat. We are getting thrown down. But at the end, like the Bible say, every tongue, every Muslim, every Buddhism, every atheists will fall down on their knees and confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen.
No matter what. I don't care how bad it look. We got to learn now to stand up for Jesus Christ. We got to get that scripture. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We got to stand that, because I had a guy told me, and this is how these so-called, I call it religion Christians. Well, I could have just said that, no, I'm not a Christian. God knows my heart. He knows. But the Bible say, if you are ashamed of me,
yes,
I will be ashamed of you.
Right.
That's what the Bible say.
If you deny him, he said, I'll deny you.
That's right. If you deny him, I'm sorry, I'm getting so excited. Deny. But this is the society. This is the religion Christianity that we live in right now. This is what is coming across. This is the false doctrine that is being taught to the people.
Isn't it amazing that it is the young people?
The young people.
That are standing.
They're standing.
That's what impresses me is when their life is on the line and they're young, they are holding up the standard of Jesus Christ. Yes, we had a visitor coming in.
I
hear him coming in. We ain't gonna freak out.
I was about to freak out. I'm about to get up. I'm a big guy. But anyway,
that's good to see Pastor Schaefer. He just stepped in the office here.
All right, Pastor Schaefer.
But so we are looking in these last days. Come on in, brother.
That's right.
That Gog and Magog is making and rising their head. That sit down, and have a seat, talk with us. Got to run.
You got to run.
Yeah, well, we appreciate you listening.
We definitely need your input, because I know you've been having a very brilliant prophetic show about the end times.
Tell me about the wall of water. Was this just a prelude?
Yeah, we was just talking about
just
that.
Just got finished talking about
that. Yeah, just got finished talking about that. That is the little warning before the big wave comes in. What we believe.
How many warnings we going to get? You remember last time the ice storm, in the middle of the ice storm, we had an earthquake?
Yep. God is being merciful to send the warnings, but we're just being ignorant not to heed them. But, you know, when you're blind and you're deaf and God has given you a spirit of stupor, then, yeah, because the Bible talks about, because they reject the truth, he will send a strong delusion, a lie, and they'll believe the lie.
That's right.
And they'll be damned. And that lie is the spirit of the Antichrist. It is operating across America. And those things are happening that are unique and new. Some people are saying, well, it's always been things like this happening. Well, you've never seen what you see in the Middle East right now.
That's right. You ain't seen China. That is very, very rare.
Yeah.
That they even put first in history, you see China actually supporting Russia and Syria come out and support. And people are still trying to figure out matter of fact, if you know, please call us 803-335-3131, 803-335-31. If you know why China is over there and what is their reason, China have no reason to be over there besides being with Putin, because they trading, they working together.
That's
you
right.
know. But to help Syria, there's something, Syria, there is like a Syria. Syria, there is something going on. Something get ready to happen. And I believe that we get ready to see the Gog and Magog war. I believe that.
Now, that may be a few months. It may be a little bit further down the line.
Who
we
knows?
Don't know.
No.
But the Federation is there.
It's there.
The Islamic nations that are mentioned in Ezekiel 38 and 39, they are all lined up.
And you know who's not there, who's leaving out? America.
Yeah, well, they're not mentioned in the scripture
either.
They're
not mentioned.
So we're not supposed to be in there.
We're not supposed to be there.
And from all points you just made and what we've talked about, we won't be there.
Yes, we won't. So there is something that's really about to take place. I don't know what it is or when it's going to be. You know, some say, hey, it can happen now, it can happen late. I don't know. All I know is we own WCC 99.9, and we telling you, if you don't have a relationship with God now, not tomorrow, not yes. half a second from now, not three quarters of a second, but now is to get a relationship with God.
Jesus is coming soon.
He's coming soon.
And at his coming, you're only going if your heart is right with God.
That's right.
And I mean living a biblically centered lifestyle.
That's right.
A lot of people are living and going to church on Sunday, and you know they're doing their own thing the rest of the week, and they're good people. Don't get me wrong. There's some good people. But they have not surrendered their life to Jesus Christ and took up a cross to follow him. The cross is where everybody stumbles.
That's right.
You understand that when
That's
it
right.
comes to being a Christian, everybody wants to be a Christian. But when it comes to carrying that cross,
that's the problem.
Everybody starts stumbling about, I want to do things. What about my life?
That's
Does
right.
my life matter? What about, I want to do this, and I want to go here, and I want my life to be like this. And you say, if I take a cross, I don't get to choose. That's exactly what I say.
And I would just got in talking about that. What about my life? Listen, God say, what about what I want you to do?
Yep.
That's the biggest thing. We gotta remember, we're not on earth to have a good time.
Amen.
We are on earth to do God's will and share the gospel. That's what God put us here for. That was the beginning of time that he had us here for until the sin happened. So by me telling you this is your purpose. You know, I was on a Facebook, and I'm going to tell you how bad that is getting for us as the pastors. I heard a black young lady, gets up there and tell the church and talking to these pastors not supporting this so-called black issue or the black movement. You church, you need to get up there. You need to get on him. You need to start giving their tithes and giving that money and tell them you need to be a part of this movement. You need to be this and that. You need to be this. I'm like, listen, wow.
You talking about the Black Lives Matter movement?
I don't know if they was Black Lives Matter or who. It was a panel of ladies, and this woman was saying that you need to get on these pastors. And then I'm like, okay, what about the word of God?
Amen.
What about that? That's more important than some color issue, because when you get to heaven, you think God going to care about a color?
Not at all.
No.
He don't care now.
He don't care now. That's why we in the position we are now. We need to remove. I mean, and this is getting, you looking at hatred is coming. Lawlessness is here. It's not coming. Hatred is here. Lawlessness here. You look at the rioting that's going on with Muslims. You look at how that we are being lied to as American citizens by our own government. We are now finding out that a lot of things, including 9/11, if you want to believe that, is set up by government. Different lies we getting found. And you know what? People are starting to open their eyes like, wow, is this really happened? Planned Parenthood. God is revealing.
Yeah, take that veil off of that.
Veil
thing.
Off. He said, listen, God
see
said,
how
listen,
ugly that is.
This, let me show you what is your nation doing. Let me show you the government you choose is the one you deserve. God is revealing and removing everything. He is showing you systematic how Satan is operating. And what do? We turn ahead. Well, I don't believe that can happen.
Yeah, when I hear Hillary Clinton on
the news,
and she's talking about women's rights and women's reproductive rights and United Way and all the other programs that, as far as she is concerned, is great programs and needs to be continued, and that she's blaming and jumping all over the Republicans. Not that I'm favoring either side at this point, but in my little illustration I want you to see is that by far there is a vast majority of people who don't care that babies are being murdered. They don't care. They say if you stop this abortion, then you're taking away a woman's right. I say if you stop abortion, you're saving a child's life.
That's right.
And what's that? You want a right or you want a life? And we're choosing to have it our way and do what we want to do. And the groups are growing everywhere. I want my right. I want this right. I would demand to have this right to marry whom I want, to believe what I want, to go. And the list never stops when they begin to demand the rights. But when you become a Christian, you take all your rights and you lay them on the altar.
That's right.
And you, when you leave that
come on,
altar,
brother.
You don't have a right. You have a cross.
Come on
And
now.
Jesus says, if any man will come after me,
yes,
let him take up a cross and follow me. So if you really want to be a Christian that's going to make it in the rapture, then you're going to have a cross and not a whole list of rights.
I mean, oh, man. And you know what? And he got me started. I'm on fire. Let's talk about all the pastors, Kenneth Copeland, Paula White, Elder McClendon, and all these other pastors that are sitting here praying for Donald Trump. To win the election. This is how.
I hadn't heard that, bro. You sharing your news with me.
I got the video. I got it on the video up on YouTube. And they actually praying for this man. This is how pathetic that we have gotten. Why would you put a man in office that don't know nothing about God, that systematically said that I don't believe, asking for God forgive me, I try to make it right. This man cares nothing about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
But sit up there and have his agenda. Why would you stoop so low to try to pray him into office? Why we can't find somebody that's a follower of Jesus Christ, that's somebody going to stand up on the word of God and will not back down, but we'll get a get a sinner, which he is, he doesn't deny, you can sit up there and say, and put him in office and think that he's going to do right. Instead of we praying and asking God, God, send us a person, or God, you send us a person to go in office and do your will, or you, we pray, God, that our government, so what we do, we pray all for a man, and he just, I mean, Donald Trump looking like, what in the world is going on? He looking around, yeah, okay, all right, it's all right, you know, he don't even know, but they giving him a Bible to make it look good.
I hadn't caught up with all that
man.
Yet.
This is how deep we done fell into the pit.
Yeah, you know, we as Christians don't have to take any substitute that the devil offers.
We don't. That's the,
God's got a better plan.
Can you say that one more time?
I says we as Christians don't have to take any old substitute the devil puts in front of us, because God's got a better plan.
And he does.
If we will humble ourselves and pray, as 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, turn from our wicked ways, seek his face, turn from our wicked ways, that he will humble, actually says humble ourselves and pray, turn from our wicked ways, then he will hear from heaven, forgive our sin, and heal our land. That's what we need.
That's what
but
we
until
need.
We humble ourselves and pray, we'll never get what God has in store.
And
you know, right now, I believe we're too far over the line.
Yes.
The whole country is too far over the line.
That's right. That's right.
We'd have to back up 100 years to get back where maybe with God where we should be, so that we can make right decisions. Right now, it's not going to happen.
It's not going
to. Judgment's coming. We don't see repentant people, no matter if God burns their land up, if he floods their land, if he, whatever he does, it doesn't matter. We do not repent. We shake our fist at God and say, we'll figure out a way to make it happen.
That's right. Like the Matthew West, do something.
Yeah.
Do something. Stop sitting. I mean, this is how, you know, the Pope come in town, and I mean, you got.
World went monkey over him, didn't
it? Oh, my goodness. Wow. I mean, you got Obama, you got T.D. Jakes, you got Rick Warren. You had all these people sitting up here. Send up a man calling him father.
That doesn't sit well with me.
It didn't. I mean, you worship one, like I said last week, 1,2700 security just for a man. Somebody posted on there one time on Facebook, and they said, I don't care nothing about when the Pope come, but just tell me when they all come out and celebrate when Jesus come.
Yeah, nobody celebrated for Jesus like that.
That's right. Nobody did it. But then we get a man here that's calling himself a God, who's getting here saying everything. Yeah, he is for against homosexuality. Yeah, but the man, come on now. Why, I'm not going to confess my sins to no man.
No.
I'm confessing to Jesus Christ.
There's only one man that
that's
can
right.
forgive you of your sin.
That's right. And we went,
Jesus
I mean,
Christ.
We, but you know, and that scripture came alive to me. Straight is the gate, narrow. I mean, when I heard that, I said, wow, there are really going to be that many people that are going to lose the faith.
Be deceived, brother.
Be deceived. And this man comes here in America, and the whole world go, even that Kim Davis. Man, I was so happy with her when she made that stand, not doing that, you know, but she get up there and meets the Pope and say that, oh, it's just like meeting God. I just love you. And will you, and the Pope say, well, will you pray for me? And she said, well, will you pray for me? And they hug, and it just, I felt exhilarating. And when I met him, I felt like I met, come on, sister, come on. How quick can you be deceived? I mean, this is, and that just took everything. I said, well, we already know where that's going.
Yeah.
But I'm not judging that. I'm just showing you what has happened. If you don't, look it up. Look it up. There's plenty. You can find a computer riding down the road. Look it up for yourself.
Well, a lot of people do need to look some of this stuff up, and
that's right.
They need to do some homework and see that we're not just trying to tell you, we're not trying to use scare tactics on anybody.
Nope.
We want you to be prepared. We want you to be ready, because hard times are coming to this country.
That's right.
Hard times are coming to the planet, because it's listed. It's already, if you want to read it, go to Book of Revelation and start reading in chapter 1. Read all the way through the end, and you'll find out God has said these things are coming. Even the New Testament, before Revelation was written, talked about in the last days, perilous
right.
times would come, because
that's
men
right.
would be lovers of themselves, not lovers of God. They'd be heady, high-minded,
mm-hmm.
Lovers of pleasure. And then the list just keeps going on, and that's exactly where we are today. And because of these things, we are in the condition as a nation that we are in, and it's going to continually escalate,
oh, yeah.
And it's going to get worse faster and like labor pains that come upon a woman. Now, Jesus said that. He said,
he
in
so
these
did.
Last days, it'd be like labor pains that come upon a woman. Well, I've watched my wife have two babies, and I know that the first pain was not that bad, and then the second pain was a little worse, and they were further apart, and then as it came time, those pains got harder and closer, but it never slowed down.
That's
it
right.
started like a slow-moving train and ended up like a jet.
Like a bullet.
Like a bullet. So what's happening in America is not going to slow down. You can watch. Natural disasters are going to continue.
That's right.
Prices are going to rise. Quality of life is going to deteriorate. Everybody worries about the economy. Don't worry about the economy. Worry about where you are with Christ.
That's right.
How is your soul? How is your relationship with Jesus Christ? How is your relationship with mom and dad and your brothers and your sisters? Because you can't go to heaven with hate in your heart.
You sure can't. Especially that hate. Hating a person, hate a person's skin color. You definitely.
You can't go to heaven with prejudice heaven like in your heart. You can't. So, you got to get this stuff out. And
that's right.
And the body of Christ ought to be the first ones to come clean on all this. We ought to be the first ones to get all of our anger, all of our hate, prejudice, all these things out of the way. And let's say, let's love Jesus with all of our mind, soul, body, and strength. And we'll be all right.
That's right. And we can't bring two religions together and say, oh, this is God.
We can't do Chrislam.
We can't do that. It's two totally different religion, two totally different. One is not a gospel. It's a false gospel. We can't do that. No matter how much they say they can do it or how much they can show unity, it does not work. If they're not follow of Jesus Christ, they don't believe that Jesus Christ was the Son of God. He rode on the third day, and he's coming back. It doesn't mix. You can't mix oil and water and expect to get water. I'm sorry.
Never heard of that word.
I ain't never sounded good,
it's
though.
It's not a word.
It's not a word. It's just
and it won't work.
It's not going to happen.
Why don't you open up the phone line, Farms? We have it a few minutes, but let's give, if we've got any caller out there that's just burning to get on, give a number.
I'm literally on fire right now. I'm like Goku from Dragon Ball Z. The number is 803-335-3131. The number is 803-335-3131. Call us with your question or comment. I know RPI is lit on fire, and me and Pat Steve, we on fire, but we just want to see y'all say. And then here's the quick thing. I know we late with it, but hey, better late than never. The way you can listen to us is, I know we always late with this. No, we always late with the time. You know, if you listen to us tomorrow and it's around about 2 o'clock, which is Wednesday, that means you listen to the rebroadcast.
2 to 3 is the rebroadcast.
2 to 3 broadcast. So you can't call us and you won't do no good. Nobody won't be here to answer.
But if you listen on Tuesday night and it's about, what, 743, you give us a call in the next few minutes at that number he just gave, and we'll be glad to entertain your question or comment to the best of our ability, at least.
At least. So if you, I'm pretty sure if they ain't listening on the internet, then they ain't listening.
So Jesus is coming, and we need to make the path straight. That was the message of John the Baptist. Make his way straight, because it's been made crooked.
Oh, crooked.
Really crooked. And now anything and everything flies, but it will not when the rapture takes place. Somebody says, you believe in the rapture? Yes, I do. Believe that in the twinkling of an eye that the saints will be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. You can call it the rapture. You can call it the catching away. You can give it any name, but Jesus is calling soon, and he's coming. You better be listening. He's calling you. Some of you are getting a call right now from Jesus
to wake
up, get busy in the kingdom, because Jesus is coming. His return is even nigh at the doors.
That's right. And you know, there was I don't know if there was another shooting in Philadelphia, but somebody had a gun and they just shut another college down and they went room to room checking. I mean, this stuff is just, you know, if you got kids in college, pray over your babies. Cover your babies.
Any school, any public school, they need to be prayed over.
They really are showing their true colors. They are attacking Christians. And I just thank God for Pineview School and Goshen Elementary. They had prayer at the pole way before the shooting started.
Amen.
And they started to do prayer, and it is a blessing. My son told me, Dad, we prayed at school. I'm like, oh, which kind of prayer? He said, Dad, you know what kind of prayer I'm talking about. So I know there's a school in Georgia that is teaching Islam.
I heard that Islam was making its way in our public schools, and the Bible has been kicked out.
Yes. So
why can't we just have it as a world religion like they're trying to slip in the Islam curriculum?
Well, I mean, hey, Islam is doing it. I was looking at an interview with this guy, and they was asking the question, do you think Sharia law, if a Muslim come out here, should they obey our constitution and do Sharia law? Out of 20 men's, two of them said constitution, the other one said Sharia law because it's God law, and they were saying, we're going to take this nation. See, we're going to take it. Y'all abort their babies, but we having babies.
Yeah.
Got a rival sword from a friend that said a Muslim come to school with 4 or 5 kids.
Right.
And
they're demographically multiplying. And did you tell me earlier that Obama had already said before the end of the year he's going to have how many thousand?
Well, 85,000. They say we're going to
85,000 Syrians.
Yeah,
that's refugees.
That's, yeah, refugees, which is I would say
mostly Syrians. Yeah.
Syrians, yeah. And they say that it went first. I said 2017. Then they heard 2016. Now I'm hearing 2015. So we don't really know. You really can't trust our media unless. And I hate to say, which I'm not hating, but unless you go to the Jerusalem Post. And you get stuff like that, or funny say, unless you're getting it from Putin. That is sad, you know. Because Putin told us, he said, listen, I'm going to let y'all know that y'all government, Obama, is lying to y'all. And he said in the future, he's going to bring out information on different things that happened in this country, which him and China probably hacked. And they're going to put it out there and tell y'all what is really going in America. So.
More information and disinformation that you got to try to decipher.
Yep, you got
to
decipher.
See, just who you're going to believe and what you're going to believe.
That's right.
And here we are in the middle of a country who can't tell the difference between light and darkness.
Wow.
What right and wrong. Husband and wife.
Lie and truth.
we're so much in this deluge of deception that we have lost our moral compass altogether, and we think that God is like us, but we are sadly deceived.
Yes.
God is not like a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. But God calls all men to repentance.
That's right.
And without repentance, there'll be no salvation. And without salvation through Jesus only, you will not truly be saved. You'll be deceived.
That's right. I mean, it's getting to the point where I had a problem when they wanted to take immigrants. You know, when I saw what happened on that Germany, they are tearing that country apart. It's getting so bad in England, till they literally just running England, taking over England. They are in the streets praying in the middle of the road, and people got to go to work, and these people stopping. Paris, they getting to the point now where England is trying to fight back. They got this one guy, I can't think of his name, and he said, we want to get England back, and he goes up there, and he goes down to the Muslim neighborhood, and buddy, they give him some trouble. They throw, they know who he is, and he said, we going to take England back. And if we take them in, this is what we're going to have in America. Which only difference in America, we kind of look rough, but I don't want to see that. If they want to come in, they want to document themselves, they want to, I'm lying. I just don't want them here. I'm just going
to you know,
I
feel sorry when I see those children, those women.
Yes, I do.
That touches my heart of compassion, and there is things that we can do to assist them and to help them, but there's things that we don't need to do to endanger our own selves in the process. They could be temporary asylums and temporary places where they could be helped, they could be housed, and then when their country in hopefully a little while is settled down, they can send them back, or they can be other places where they can have their own little place. Find them an island, yeah. You find them a spot that nobody's using, and you give them the food and the water. There's no difference in taking them in and giving them welfare as it is to find them somewhere to stay, and then when they get a chance, could go back home.
Yeah.
I don't close up my bowels of compassion against their plight, but I also know that it can be a ploy,
and it
can be used against us to destroy our nation.
Yes, and we've seen it right now. I mean, in Germany, it's getting to the point now that they can't use the police; they use the military.
Yeah, to try to police.
Try to police because they just come in riding. They want this. They want that. I mean, and these not a peaceful people. I mean, for what I'm seeing, it's. I talked to some Muslims. The ones I talked to ain't like that. I mean, I don't, you know, and we come to a different of agreement, but we also come to the fact that, you know, you have your stand with your religion in mind, and that's it. But the ones I seen, they got coming, they just, first they started people riding, they thought throwing bricks and knives, and I mean, it's just, And I'm just, you know, because we all immigrants in America. I mean, if anybody should get a right, it's the Indians.
Indians got their natives, right?
That's right. You know, I mean, that's why I kind of, you know, Donald Trump talking about, well, I should build a wall. No, for what? I mean, if anything, you know, the Indians should be like, well, how you going to build a wall? What about us? You know, I mean, just be real with it. You know, we took the land from them and did what we did. But, you know, hey, but now we trying to take immigrants in. And some of these people don't look like immigrants. They look like big old soldiers.
Well,
you know?
That's what some of them, I believe, are. Yeah. They're trying to get in and infiltrate so that they can do terrorist acts inside the countries which welcome them.
That's right.
And that's the ploy of this whole thing. And anybody with half a brain cell can figure it out.
That's right.
They come in as refugees, but in reality, they're setting up terrorist groups.
That's right.
And we welcome them in. We're giving them food, shelter, clothing, and that gives them all the time they need to try to build a cell and do terrorist activities, or at least just get it started.
And guess,
in another country.
And guess what I saw when I looked at the video, because they've been posting it like crazy. I mean, I've been, you know, doing the Jerusalem Journal and all that. And guess what flag they are waving?
Syria
ISIL flag waving. That's all you see. I'm like, wow.
It's crazy, isn't it?
It is. So
this world is in turmoil.
Yes, it is.
The world don't know what to do with the situations that are at hand. And that is because God has taken all the wisdom from the nations.
That's right.
He's letting them begin to form their own opinions, do their own things. But in the end, they'll turn and fight against one another. And the Gog-Magog War, it talks about that. This federation of nations that comes against Israel in these last days, led by Russia, led by maybe even Putin himself, if he's still there, as the political leader. When they come in, that God will turn them one against the other, and then that Israel will bomb them. And it talks about how great the destruction will be. And then it says God will send down hailstones from heaven to them that try to escape.
You know what? That sounds familiar with Joshua. Remember when Joshua was they sent out, the God said, send boulders.
They fell from heaven to kill those trying to escape.
They killed more people than Joshua them killed. So when you got the power of Jesus Christ behind you, you don't have nothing to worry about. Like God told me back in July, he said, I want you to tell the people two things, RPI or Patrick. He said, I want you to tell them that I am coming soon and that those who serve me, I will protect. Now, it may be a situation where he take you home, maybe a situation where he keeps stuff happening, but this is what God has told me that.
He's going to take care of his own.
He's going to take care of his own.
Yep.
Now, I do not hate Muslims. I do not. I love them.
I want them all to get saved.
I pray for them. Hey, I had a chance to witness to a few of them, and I was surrounded, but I didn't have no fear. And they was the nicest people. One of them didn't care too much what I was talking about, but
you listen.
They listen,
which is more than what a lot of Americans are doing.
That's right, and they listen, and I listen to them. You know what they saying? So it's like, you know, I don't hate them. I don't, you know, if the immigrants are gonna come here, let's get this all, you know, let's weave them out. Come on, we can do that. They've been doing it for so long. Like I tell everybody, at one point in time, everybody in this country is an immigrant.
That's right. I agree.
That's right. You know, just like I say, at one point in time, everybody was slaves. I mean, everybody was. It was, you know, you can't say, well, you know, the black was slaves. You got the Jews. You got the Israelites. You got even, I was reading about the Irish. The poor Irish people were slaves, you know. So, I mean.
Well, you had indentured servants.
Yes.
You had sharecropping, and it wasn't matter skin color. It was a matter of, that's just the way things were at the time. And, Brother Patrick, I am so grateful that God has given us a great free country.
Yes.
And that now all races can excel.
That's right.
Everybody can excel. And thank God for this country. But this country has left God.
That's right.
We're not that shining city on a hill anymore. So we're trying as WCC radio station to reach out and get some course corrections made for our country, some course corrections for our churches. They're churches who won't face the issues. They've got a candy religion. They've got a candy Christianity, and it makes them feel good when they go to church. They hear good music. They hear a good sermon. But they're not connected with what's going on in the world, and they're not praying.
They're not
fasting. They're not reading their Bible. They are churchy people, and that's all they are. They are prey for the devil. The devil's got most of them deceived, and they think that that's all right. They're going to make heaven their home someday, and they'll have a great life just the way they planned it.
Wow.
But without that cross, brother, you know, nothing. I like that that's the song that says, I'll trade this old cross for a crown. But you go to that pearly gate without a cross on your back, that means you suffered and you gave everything, even all of your life for Jesus Christ. You go to that gate without that cross, and you knock on that door, and you don't have a cross to trade, my friend, you'll be turned right around.
That's right.
Because you can trade a cross for a crown, but you don't get to trade anything you brought up with yourself.
That's right.
Your doctor's degree, your big accolades, you can say you did. No, you better have a cross.
That's right. And you better carry that thing. Go when you carry the cross, go through the trial.
Go through it. Yeah.
Because
it's coming.
I learned a long time ago. I said, God, take me out of this trial. Then he take me out. But I go through the same trial, different situation. Never finish the trial. Never. So I asked God. I said, God, take me through it, trusting in you.
Yeah.
And I went through it. I got a blessing out of it, but I got so much wisdom.
That's right. If you don't face something, you don't get nothing.
You don't get nothing. And sometimes it don't necessarily have to be money. It can be wisdom because, man, if you got wisdom and that wisdom help you produce money or produce a relationship or produce this or do that, you sit on a gold mine.
Wisdom is greater than riches.
It is.
Greater than silver or gold.
It is, you know. But, I mean, it's amazing to see all this open up. Even CERN, I mean.
Yeah, isn't that an amazing machine?
Yeah, machine open up, and they claim that they open a portal and all that stuff like that. So, I mean, there's so much stuff going on. Wow. All I can say is wow.
Jesus, well, we didn't come to the end of this hour. It seems to pass by very, very quick.
That's right.
I do encourage our leaders to read and study Ezekiel 38 and 39. Please take the time to read it.
Yeah, that's right.
You can look on Google and just say Ezekiel 38, 39 nations, and it'll give you the nations as they are today. And you can see the listings there in your Bible, what they're called in Ezekiel's day. But you can get their names for today. And boy, will your eyes pop wide open when you see these are all nations that are either Islam extremist or, like Russia, is going to lead the extremist nations, the Islamic nations, against Israel in the last days. Watch it happen. Open your eyes. God is showing us things we need to be seeing so we'll understand the seasons and the times that we're living in.
Amen. So you have been listening to In the Last Days. I am the co-host, RPI, Radio Pastor Isaac. And I just hope what we said, that you really take it to heart. You know, a lot of things were said, and I know sometimes RPI get a little excited and get over juiced. But the purpose of me is just sharing the gospel and get you prepared. I don't want to see nobody left behind, which, unfortunately, there are going to be some people left behind because they just don't care. But I am saying, God bless you. I love you, and trust in God. As Pastor Steve, take us out.
With RPI, I appreciate you running the boards tonight, and I know you're going to go over there and do a little switching over for us. And I want to thank all of our listening audience tonight. You've been listening to Pastor Steve Hall, the host for the show, pastor of the Johnston Church of God, and I've been your host for the show tonight. I hope that you have taken away something in your heart that prompts you to draw close to God, to get your heart right with God, so that when he comes, you'll be ready to meet him. Or if trouble and heartaches come, which they do to all of us, but even more so in these last days, that you'll be able to weather each storm with the help and the grace of God. All right, we love you. We thank you for listening. Stay tuned for some more great programming coming right up here on WCC 99.9.
Let's get it on. Uh-oh. All everybody in the world saw me fall.